Recorded Books and RB Digital present The Sea Lion by Cynthia Rylant, illustrated by Preston McDaniels, read by Mark Nelson. Chapter 1, Fall Days. There stands above the dark blue sea a solitary lighthouse that once was the home of only a solitary lightkeeper, Pandora the Cat. Pandora had pledged her life to the protection of all the sailing ships. Faithfully, night and day, she tended the lights, and she did her best not to feel lonely, but this was not always easy. Then one day, Pandora's life changed completely when a storm threw onto her shore a sailor named Seabold and his broken little boat, Adventure. Pandora had company. She helped Seabold regain his health, and she watched as he repaired his boat to return to the sea. A goodbye was near at hand. But before Seabold could set sail, there was yet another rescue. Pandora and Seabold found three orphaned children drifting in a crate in the sea, afraid and hungry. Their names were Whistler, Lila, and Tiny, and they very much needed a home. They found one. Not only a home with Pandora in the protection of her lighthouse, but remarkably, a home with Seabold as well, for the noble sailor came to care about them so much that he decided to stay, to help look after them, and to be of use. And this is how the Lighthouse Family was made. Fall was a beautiful time of year at the lighthouse. Out at sea, the gray whales migrating south blew heart-shaped spray to say hello to Pandora, for they had known the kind cat for many years. Blueberries growing in deep thickets attracted thousands of swallows, who swooped down for a big meal before flying to catch up with the whales. And in the evenings, sunsets cast a deep red glow over all the windows of the tall tower. Summers were also playful times for the Lighthouse Family, but in the fall, Pandora and Seabold got serious about lightkeeping again. Any day now, there would be the first fog of the season, and the windows and the prisms in the lantern room had to be spotless. Seabold was always going up and down the ladder with polishing rags in his hands. Pandora passed pails of lantern oil to him, for the giant lamp that burned each evening to warn sailors away from the dangerous rocks. Because the children only had a short time left for playing safely outside before winter arrived, Pandora urged them to go and explore. "Are you sure you don't need us to polish?" Whistler asked as he and Lila headed for the door every day. "No, my dears," said Pandora, "your work is to play." Whistler and Lila smiled. It was nice to have that sort of work. The children then left the cottage and their baby sister Tiny, who enjoyed being the baby in the house, and they went out to see what they might find. Pandora sent them with pockets full of special candies made of cherries and lavender flowers. "To keep you nicely fed until supper," she said. Whistler and Lila loved to explore. There were so many different places to go, and one never knew what one might find. This day, Whistler and Lila saw a snowy owl perching at the very top of a high sand dune, surveying all the land and sea. "He is thinking about the great wide world," said Whistler. Lila nodded. They were both admirers of the owl, whom they saw now and then. Soon the owl would fly back to the Arctic, Seabold had told them. But at present, he was here. The children climbed the rocky slopes covered with wild roses, heading for the secret cove used by the whale mothers as a day nursery for their babies. The babies swam in circles while the mothers went away for a little while to do whatever mother whales do. Whistler and Lila hoped somebody might be in the cove today, but there were no baby whales, only some black-tailed deer enjoying a bite of kelp on the rocks. The polite children tried to be very quiet, so as not to disturb the deer, but they walked over a patch of rockweed, and it made a loud pop-pop-pop when they did. The deer saw them and ran away. Deer were always shy.
"So sorry," called Lila.
"Sorry," said Whistler.
But there were others who did enjoy the children's company. On the mud flats, the sea scallops loved being chased by the children. When Whistler and Lila reached down to tag...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.